Converting within the customary system. The customary system is a set of measurements used to measure length, weight, capacity, and temperature. The United States is one of three countries in the world that uses the customary system instead of the metric system. Your sixth grade math reference chart has some of the most common conversions in the customary system. For example, the chart tells us that 1 foot is equal to 12 inches. Let's say that you are given a problem and are told that a boy is 60 inches tall, but the problem wants you to determine how tall the boy is in feet. You can use the conversion of 1 foot equals 12 inches to help you determine the answer. To find the answer, you first need to set up a ratio. Since you know that 1 foot is equal to 12 inches, your ratio can be 1 foot over 12 inches. The problem told you that the boy is 60 inches tall, so you can start writing another ratio and fill in 60 inches on the bottom of the ratio. You are basically writing a proportion. The only unknown that you have is how tall the boy is in feet. Once you have written your proportion, you can find a scale factor that you can use to determine how tall the boy is in feet. If you multiply 12 by 5, you will get 60. Therefore, 5 will be your scale factor. Now, you can multiply 1 by 5 to get your answer, which is 5 feet. The boy is 5 feet tall. However, sometimes we come across situations where we need to convert between other measurements within the customary system. For example, if I have 1 gallon of milk, how many cups do I have? If you look at your sixth grade math reference chart, you will not see a conversion for gallons to cups. You will, however, see conversions for gallons to quarts, quarts to pints, and pints to cups. We can use these conversions to help us determine how many cups are in a gallon. First, we need to set up a ratio with the conversions we have with gallons. We can write 1 gallon over 4 quarts. Next, we will write a second ratio of 1 quart to 2 pints. Then, one last ratio is 1 pint equals 2 cups. Remember the trick that you were taught when multiplying fractions, cross-cancel. We're going to cross-cancel similar units. To do this, we need to look at the diagonals of our ratios that we created. Notice that quarts and pints are diagonal from each other. We can cross-cancel both quarts and pints, but only the words, not the numbers, because they are already in lowest terms. The last thing that we would need to do for this problem is to multiply across. The remaining unit on top will remain on the top, and the remaining unit on the bottom will remain on the bottom. When we multiply across, we should get 1 gallon over 16 cups, which gives us our answer. There are 16 cups in 1 gallon.